All right, hello everyone. Thanks again for tuning in to our Facebook Live about the Amazon effect for the second time. Hopefully Facebook cooperates and doesn't eat our video. But thanks to everyone who did watch on Wednesday. But I'm back again with Melody Simmons, our real estate reporter, to talk about the massive report on Amazon that we had come out. We posted it online on Wednesday, and today we have the print edition that came out that should have gone out to all of our subscribers. So Melody, you want to tell everyone a little bit about what this project entails?
Yes, this is a the culmination of 6 months of work and research, and special report shows that 43 newsrooms across the United States, the ACBJA, the business journals, show that there has been a large number of tax breaks given to Amazon to allow it to grow. So the taxpayers are really funding a lot of the growth of this private company that has basically $30 billion in cash reserves.
And obviously Amazon has a large presence in Baltimore. You have the facility in South Baltimore, there's one up in Cecil County, there's talks of another one in Sparrows Point. What has this company done locally? What kind of local incentives have they received?
Well, Baltimore's no exception to the rule. The city gave Amazon $40 million back in 2013 to, that's when the discussion started, to open a new facility here, which opened 1.1 million square foot, a distribution center in the city in 2015. It brought in a lot of jobs, which is what the officials thought it would balance out and pay for itself with the incentives because of the jobs that have come in. And they have more than doubled that number of jobs.
So what does this mean going forward? Obviously the big HQ2 deadline is looming on October 19th. Baltimore is pushing for Port Covington to be selected as the site for Amazon's second North American headquarters. What can we kind of expect to see from the state and local government and Amazon going forward?
I think what we're seeing right now is a giant Lollapalooza for headquarters, HQ2. This is happening all over America right now. The deadline is next Thursday, October 19th. And so between now and then, we're going to have a lot of negotiations, a lot of teeth gnashing with development officials in every city and state just about in the United States. Everybody wants this. It's a $5.5 billion investment by Amazon, and also the promise of 50,000 jobs. So what city wouldn't want it?
So talk to me about what kind of reporting went into this. Obviously you had to talk to a lot of local officials. There's a lot of documents and numbers to comb through. What was the process of reporting the story?
We started out very low. We got a game plan, and then we started to release the Freedom of Information Act requests. These are letters that go out to city agencies, state agencies. We wanted to see emails. We wanted to see documents. We received thousands of documents. And then you start going through that and start to really start your reporting on it. And this is basically a roadmap of Amazon's entry into Maryland and how Amazon has set itself up as a giant retailer using Interstate 95 as the main vein.
All right, well, thank you very much, Melody, for talking to us and the viewers out there. Obviously, there's a lot more that you can read on the website about this project. We just had a story that went up last night about the incentives that Maryland might offer. I'm sure there's going to be more Amazon follow-ups along the way. So if you would like to, please check those out online on our social media feeds. Melody, you're going to be on WBAL Radio.
Yes, Monday morning.
Monday morning, talking about this project. You're already on WYPR today, yes, discussing it. So there's a lot more to hear about it. And if you follow us on all of our social media channels, you can keep up with everything that we have to offer.
Story moving.